Okay, everybody, I'm gonna be making an Amish casserole. It's a recipe that I got from a friend of mine, and I haven't made it yet, but I wrote it all down. And I'm gonna make this video while I do it. 1 second, let me find a knife. It's an Amish country casserole. Got 1 teaspoon of olive oil. I guess it doesn't care what brand. I got this brand. 1 medium-sized onion chopped, 1 pound ground beef, 1 16-ounce pack of wide egg noodles, 1 10¾ can of condensed tomato soup, 1 10¾ can condensed cream of mushroom, 1 cup of milk, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of pepper, and 1/2 teaspoon of paprika. Okay, but I'm not gonna use regular salt. I'm gonna use seasoned salt. And I'm not going to use regular pepper, I'm going to use lemon pepper. And garlic powder. And the paprika it called for. And onion powder. I'm going to make mine a little bit different. So let's cut up the onion first. I don't know if y'all can see me. Let me phone up somehow. It may not work because I got the charger on it. Maybe this will help. But I'm chopping up an onion. Hold on 1 second. Hold on, I'll be right back. Let me go get my tripod. Actually, I don't think the tripod's gonna work. Cause I got a pop socket on my phone. So, let's try it a different way. Pop it up a different way. There we go. So y'all can see what I'm doing. Okay, I got an onion. I don't know how much of it I'm going to use. It says it's a medium-sized onion, so I guess I have to use it all. I hate cutting onions. Let me get some measuring cups. Gonna cut this onion up. Probably best just to peel the whole thing just in case. Okay, let me throw this away. Get a bowl for the onions. And I'll read the directions as I go. I don't know exactly if that was a medium-sized onion. but I'm just going to do the best I can. Like I said, the only thing I'm doing different is adding a few spices. And of course, you're going to need some hamburger meat. I think everybody hates cutting onions. Okay, you got that part cut. Let me cut the rest of them. Sorry, I had to wipe my eyes for a minute. I'm trying to turn away from the onion so my eyes don't get watery again. Maybe I should have cut this up before I started a video. But I wanted to do it as I went. Got the onion cut up.
Watch my countertop off.
So that way you don't leave a mess. Okay. First thing you do, okay, is preheat oven to 375, coat a 3-quart casserole dish with cooking spray, which I will do that last, and large skillet, heat oil on medium height. Okay, so we're going to heat oil, olive oil. We need a tablespoon. That's if I can open it. Oh, I was opening it the wrong way. My bad. Okay. Okay, let me get a tablespoon. I guess this is a tablespoon. Put a cup for 1 tablespoon of oil. But I'm going to put 2 just in case. And rub it around in the pan so it's all covered. Okay. Large skillet, heat oil on medium heat, I'm sorry. So let's heat up the oil. And then we'll put in the onion and saute it for 2 or 3 minutes, and then we'll add the ground beef and stuff. So we gotta heat the oil. And the last thing would be, in a large soup pan, cook noodles according to package directions. Drain well, return noodles to pot, add ground beef mixture and remaining ingredients except for paprika. Placing prepared dish and sprinkle with paprika, cover and bake till heated through 25 to 30 minutes, but I'll probably cook it 30 minutes. So let me get the oil heated up and then I'll put the onion. It will come on. Let's go ahead and read the direction on the menu. It calls for a 10 3/4 ounce, but I got 2 12. I got 2 12 packs. Well, not 12 packs, 12 ounces. So let's go ahead and get the water heated. Let me get some water for the noodles. And we're gonna need regular oil for the noodles so they don't stick. And of course, regular salt. Okay, I guess we can put the onions in now. I don't know if it's too soon or not. Okay, here's the water for the noodles. I put the salt in there. I'm trying to saute the onions. Maybe I should turn it up a little bit. I know I got it on the wrong eye. Maybe I didn't have it on high enough. Okay, let that saute. Let me get the spices ready. Oh, I don't need to open yet. I forgot to turn the water on. Okay, just turn the water on for the noodles. Okay, let me set the timer. I'm trying to set the timer for 3 minutes. Okay, we're going to saute these for 3 minutes. Hold on, let me turn the heater off. Okay, we're sauteing the onions right now. Excuse the wire. Let me get it out of the way. Hamburger meat. In a bowl and mix it up, but it's the first time I've ever sauteed onions. Let me get a bowl. I'm just going to go ahead and put my hamburger meat in a bowl. Yes, my hands are clean. I washed my hands. And and I will wash them again. After I get this mixed up. You're not supposed to put the paprika into the top, but I'm just going to season my meat. Season salt. Lemon pepper. Onion powder. Well, I was going to put garlic powder, but we have no more, so subtract this one. You don't have to saute your onions for a whole 3 minutes. It only said 2 to 3 minutes. And then you can add your hamburger meat. I put it on 3, but it's already down to 255. When it's 159, I'll go ahead and add a hamburger meat. And this is my first time sauteing onions. I'll take them off when it gets to 2. Hold on 1 second. I know I'm eventually going to have to spray a casserole dish. So I got to get some cooking spray. We hardly ever buy cooking spray, but one time I got it. Casserole dish, so I'm gonna be using a pan. Okay. honestly think they're sauteed enough, but once I pay, like I said, 2 to 3 minutes, preferably 2, not 3. So now we're just waiting. Okay, so I gotta get out the milk. I'm gonna call for a cup of milk. Let me go ahead and pour the milk in here. Cup of milk. Trying to saute the onions. And I got the water boiling. I'll show you what the onions are looking like. That's the onions. And of course I got the water boiling. You know what? I know the timer is at 2:48, but I think they are sauteed enough, so I'm just going to cancel it. I'm going to go ahead and add the meat, because I don't want to burn them. Okay, so I'm going to add the meat. I think they're sauteed enough. Okay, now we're going to cook this until it's brown. The hamburger meat. I think I'm going to have to find a metal spatula. Hold on, everybody. Let me find my metal spatula. Here it is. I hate when people put the wrong thing in the wrong drawer. It gets on my nerves. Because I try to stay organized. And it's hard to stay organized when people are doing the total opposite. Maybe I just need one pack. I'm gonna put both of them just in case. Okay, everybody, I got the noodles in the pot. They didn't have a 16 ounce, so I just got 2 12. So that's gonna make it a little bit extra. I got the noodles going. I got that going. Now I just gotta spray. See. Spray the pan. Okay. Does it say drain well, return noodles to pot, add your ground beef mix and remaining ingredients. Okay. I'll have to add the milk later. Let me spray the pan. Okay, got the pan sprayed. Here. Noodles are boiling. I'll try a noodle in just a second. Let that cool off. And get the can opener. Okay. Let me open the soup. A little bit longer. I'm gonna have to find a bigger pan though, because I gotta add all that other stuff to this soup. So let me wash the pot, everybody. Okay, let me stir the meat. The meat's not quite done yet. Hold on, and I'll check the noodles. Hold on. Okay, everybody, the noodles are done. We're just waiting on the meat. I'm watching a bigger pot so I can add the other stuff to it. Now we gotta drain the noodles. Drain noodles. This over here. Hey everybody, I got the noodles drained. So as soon as the meat's done, I'll add the meat. We're waiting for the meat to finish cooking. Then I can add the meat and then the other stuff. Just in case I have to add another cup because I use an extra pack of noodles, I'm going to get the milk back out. Just in case I have to use another cup. Okay, everybody, the meat's done, so I'm going to drain the meat real quick, and then we're going to add it to the noodles. Now it says, add ground beef mixture and remaining ingredients except for the paprika. And mix well. So I'm going to use 2 cups of milk. Just to be on the safe side. Okay, now we're going to add the seasonings again. And we're going to add this food. And I guess 3 of these. Okay, now we're gonna add the soup. It's a 26 ounce. So, you know what? I'll just go ahead and use the whole can just in case. Just to be on the safe side. Okay, I got that soup added. Now I gotta add this one. This away. Okay, now we're gonna mix it, everybody. It says to mix well. This is what it looks like before you mix it. I'll show you what it looks like after. So let me try to mix it. Okay. Hold on, everybody. I'm trying to mix it. Okay, now we're gonna put it in the casserole dish. I think maybe I made too much. Oh well. Okay. Put it in the casserole dish. I know I made a lot. I'm probably gonna have to make a little one too. So hold on, everybody. We find that other one. Let me get that spray since I have to make two of them. And the rest of them I'm going to put in this plastic. If I can hold it. Hold on. Fix and add the paprika, and then I'll show you what it looks like. Make sure there's nothing in the oven. Okay, now we gotta preheat the oven to 375. Stop. Okay, now that oven's been heated, we're gonna put everything away. And then I'll show you what it looks like. And like I said, I don't know how it's going to turn out because this is my first time. Let me turn my camera around so I can show you. There's one. And there's two. I made too much, and like I said, it's called Amish Country Casserole. I'll show it one more time, so if y'all want to write it down, y'all can. I'll hold it up for a few minutes. Okay, everybody, thank you for watching. Like and subscribe down below. Hit the notification bell so every time I post a video, you'll know. Thank you for watching. Stay safe out there and be careful. And always remember to wear your mask. Bye now.